Pranaya, guys, y'all ready? Review over your, kind of quietly going, you go over in your minds.
I forgot the pointer, but I have my finger.
Oh, yeah, that's fine. Kind of go over in your minds what you're, be standing together, figure out where you're going to stand. Do you guys know where you're going to stand?
Not really.
So Vanilla, come here, Okay, so put it on the
system at work?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So actually on that day we went to a lab with a professor and he literally just taught us. He taught us all the ways how to build a system and we built it ourselves. And
so this is something you guys did yourselves?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. With the help of somebody else. But whenever you think of
it. So why is it that we still see hydroponics separately from aquaculture as opposed to combining them?
I think it's because a lot of people don't know what aquaponics is. Mm-hmm. Because before this, I really didn't know what there was a thing as hydroponics and aquaculture. Mm-hmm. So,
So knowledge may be one of them, but you know, I mean, I didn't know. You know about this arrow one. So, what are the reasons why people don't know about it? Is it because it's too expensive, or people aren't talking about it? Why aren't farmers adopting aquaponics much more in their regular day-to-day business activity?
Well, it might be because you have to get systems set up. Mm-hmm. And you have to buy the fish and the plants, but after the system is set up, it becomes kind of easy because you don't use a lot of water for one, and the fish automatically provides fish the waste, mm-hmm. and the waste is good for the plants because mm-hmm. it has nutrients, that's what it's called, and that's good for the plants. Mm-hmm. Nutrients help plants grow, and it is cheaper, but first buying the base and all the materials and the pumps. It can be a little. I think it might be a little intimidating and basically regular farming.
I see.
So, are there areas of the world that are utilizing this or implementing this more than, say, in the United States, or does it differ?
Well, it kind of depends because an aquaponics system can be made anywhere and in their own home. So it's probably more in areas where there's not a lot of water, and people need to grow plants and food. So you go to aquaponics because there's much less water, and it's likely it's kind of a better option for them. And I would see there'd be a lot more systems there, and there'd be in a place with a lot of water and traditional farming.
We take a look at your diagram here. What?
The plants are naturally filter the water for the fish.
Okay.
And they catch a lot of bacteria that can be after the fish and move them instead.
So then, what would happen to the bacteria that are left if they're not catching the bacteria? What's the plastic thing?
Well, the sediment basin catches all that.
Pardon me.
The sediment basin catches all that.
Oh, okay.
in the human intent phase between our love and our mind, as well as their plants can't afford it.
So, after having done this project, are any one of you interested in following either one of these careers?
I'm actually really interested in aquarius and electrical designing because I'm really interested in DIYs, and an electrical designer, it helps design electrical devices and stuff, so I would like, I'm interested in that career.
Mm-hmm. What about you?
I am in robotics and I like to code, so I would probably choose electrical designer, but I'm also into life science, so I might choose a farmer, but I would rather go for the electrical designer.
Well, I really like aquaponics and my fishes. I love animals and plants. So aquaponics does sound good thing for me, but I kind of want to focus on more than just fishes and more on deer.
Like a veterinarian.
Veterinarian. Or make plants.
Land biologist. Very cool. Well, thank you very much.
So we have a chant that we made up literally yesterday. So yes. When I say aqua, you say ponics. Aqua.
Ponics.
Aqua.
Ponics.
Rachel Sunchop.